Okay, it's Down Beach Buzz, and it is July 19th, 2017. We're looking at some video from last night, July 18th, 2017, flying over the beaches of Margate. And we want to thank Ron T. Brown, an aerial pilot, a drone pilot. Ron T. Brown, great footage. And what does the T stand for? It stands for terrific. That's what. Thanks, Ron. So we are taking a look at some high-quality, high-definition drone footage as we head southbound. I think Ron is getting started from the Ventnor Boardwalk, the ending, right there, the borderline of Margate and Ventnor, right there at Fredericksburg. This gives you an idea of the massiveness of this project. I'm no engineer. I don't have a ruler that long. But this project is not moving along at 1,000 feet or 1,000-foot increments at a time. It seems like it just keeps on expanding because the pipe that comes from the dredge offshore makes its way onto the beach at Fredericksburg and then takes a left. So you're always going to see this pipe. Notice the length all the way down. So even though some of these beaches, you can see right here, there's a lifeguard stand, and you can see these crossovers. Yeah, that beach is open, technically, but it's a bit unattractive in a way. The sand, the quality of the sand in this part of the beach, it's kind of a thicker consistency, more a little more gravel-like, maybe more broken shells. And you can see at the lower end of your screen there, that is the pipe that comes out of the surf that heads all the way out to the dredge, the hopper dredge. And we have about 2 minutes of raw footage here. I'm going to run it again. Ron's going to get some other footage as well. But what we're looking at right now is the northern part of Margate. And that is where Mr. John Amadeo, Commissioner John Amadeo of Margate, not too happy. When he literally 2 weeks ago, he said, listen, guys, he talked to the DEP, say, listen, can you not close both of these beaches, this whole section? You're killing the whole section. There's like 3 lifeguard stands here. And for about 8 days, you could either not swim or you could swim, but you had to go over all kinds of landmines in a way. You had to go over the muddy dead zone to the right. We call this the dead zone. This is where they graded down kind of a trough, kind of a drainage area between the bulkhead and the new dune. You might not be able to see it exactly, but right here where I'm taking my cursor back and forth, that's the new dune. And they have been moving along pretty quick. They can do dunes. They can build a dune pretty fast. But it's the beach extension that takes some time because they have to hold back the water. That's right, holding back the water. Chew on that for a minute. Holding back Mother Nature. So this was done last night, July 18th. But to our screen left, this pipe is waiting for another hopper dredge because probably for the past 2 days, that dredge has not been there. Maybe it's in for maintenance. But we did notice that pumping of sand has stopped for the past 2 days, the 18th and the 19th of July. But those bulldozers at the top of your screen, they're pushing sand back and forth and doing some work. But let's take a look along the top of the dune. You can see that some of the passovers or the crossovers, the walkways, are starting to be constructed. This dark orangey brownish clay, kind of a mixture of some stones and dark thicker clay. That's being pumped in or being brought in by dump truck. And it's making its way all the way from Suffolk Avenue in Ventnor. That's the point where they bring in all the pipe. That is a staging area, if you will. And they bring these dump trucks down and they dump it there, in these piles. Then they carve out these zigzags or these crossovers. Some of them ADA compliant, good for those with disabilities or those who need to have a wheelchair. but it does look like each and every street will have a crossover. But bear in mind, when you walk over the bulkhead, up and down those steps, you then have to walk through the dead zone, the mud, and the area that literally looks like quicksand because it's about 5 or 6 inches above, I guess, the water table, because when you dig down maybe 5 inches, water comes up right away. That area doesn't seem to dry out. Then you have to walk up this dune and then walk down and then find your way up and down this pipe and look for that crossover, like right here. And then you can get to the beach. I did notice that this beach was open for swimming recently. And the reason why I think some of these beaches reopened for swimming is because they stopped dredging. A couple of days ago, they disconnected all this pipe. They were all in individual 30-foot segments. A day later, they were all put back together again. I try to ask a lot of questions from a lot of different people that look like they're connected to the project, and they all give me slightly different answers, or they just kind of smile. They're all very nice and kind, but they keep their answers to a minimum. And one person did let me know that they thought there was some kind of a clog. Maybe that is the reason why there was bacteria or reports of higher levels of bacteria shutting down swimming between the Ventnor Pier, as you can see here. I'm sorry, the Margate Pier down here, Essex Avenue. And you couldn't swim between here and all the way up to about here. Well, you actually couldn't even come up here anyway because of the construction. But I wouldn't be swimming anywhere near here whenever there's pumping and dredging and stuff like that. So let's play this again. Let's stop it right here. As you can see, the boardwalk, the end of the Ventnor boardwalk, is right here. The top of the dune is here. It is kind of interesting to walk along the top of the dune, but very soon you will not be able to do that. But this family and many of us, you know, you have to go up there to get over the dune to get onto the beach. So even though technically the beach is open, this is what you're traversing. This is what you are going through. And people are either putting their chairs down, their blankets, or they're taking a stroll along the top of the dune, which will one day be filled with dune grass. And you will not be allowed to walk on the dune soon. Anyway, so this is coming out of the ocean from left to right. It takes a left, and you wonder, how the heck are they pumping all that sand all the way down? They have these pumps that they'll stick in there in the middle somewhere to give it more power to boost it and boost that stuff further down the beach. Let's hit the play button here. Got some dogs taking a little run, kind of interesting. And you can see, even though the actual work takes up maybe 1,000 feet at a time, the residual, the residue, the stuff they leave behind still disrupts, still screws up the beauty of the beach. Can you get around it? Yeah. But it is disingenuous to say, well, we're only going to really affect 1,000 feet at a time. But that noise travels up to a mile. And sometimes you see these tractors just sticking in the middle of the beach. Is it bothering you? I don't think so, but, you know, can you move your crap out of the way? And you can see those sand crossovers to the far right. This gives you an idea of just how far they're getting. Let's stop it right here. So you can see we're all the way down, getting closer to the Margate Pier. It takes a left here, and this yellow outfall, I think it's called an outfall filter, and it filters out anything too big. Remember, we talked about how these yellow outfall pipes or these filters are commonplace now, because back in the day up in LBI, Long Beach Island, and they were doing dredging and dune work up there, and they were literally digging up stuff from the bottom of the ocean, digging up old munitions, ammunition from World War II was being thrown up on the beach. Thus, they have to put those yellow filters to make sure nothing more than a granule of sand or some gravel gets through. There's a yellow one here, a yellow one here. And you can see exactly how much space it's taking up. Right now, the project is not moving down the beach. It literally is expanding. It's expanding. Will this work save lives? Will it protect property? Will it lower flood insurance rates? How long will this extended beach last? Anybody want to make a wager? And it is true. Local newspaper and local radio absolutely had no idea, or they ignored it. A lot of these beaches were closed for swimming over the past 9 days. They're either too stupid, they don't have enough manpower, or they kept it buried. And I understand you want to keep it on the down low. We don't want to scare people away. But what do? Let people come all the way down to find out that the beach might be, and the water might be contaminated because of all this dredging work? There's plenty of beach and plenty of water throughout Absecon Island and Margate and Ventnor to enjoy while this crap is going on. But it's foolish to think that you can keep this stuff hidden. Most people we talk to on the boardwalk or walking along viewing all this stuff, a majority of them didn't know how big the impact was. They didn't know it was going to be this invasive. Remember, visitors and second homeowners, those who are not here full time, they don't see and hear the local media. They don't see this happening until they get down here. And quite frankly, the local media, WND, local radio, I don't even know if they don't know what's going on. I don't know if they're lying or they're stupid or they don't want to talk about it. Press of Atlantic City didn't talk about it. I'm just thinking that when you have a high elevated bacteria level on a swimming beach, it might become news. Hello? Hello? Anybody home? Local media? Berkshire Hathaway? Press of Atlantic City? Hello? You guys still journalists? You know, journalism used to be about not just sharing public service announcements and feel-good stories, but it put pressure on local elected leaders to be transparent. Kind of like watchdog journalism. Well, when you have a one newspaper town, they determine what's news and what's not. They get to amplify one thing and ignore the other. But this interweb thing. So thanks to Ron T. Brown for this great aerial photography, this drone video. And what does T stand for from Ron T. Brown? Terrific. Hey, please join our email newsletter. It's growing because people trust us, except for the people inside of Ventnor City Hall. They don't trust us. They believe that we should be spending more time taking pictures of the surf and of sunsets. And I figured, you know, a lot of people do that already. They do a great job. Why don't I just point it at these big, giant news stories? You know, zillions of dollars being spent on stuff that probably will not really save lives and protect local property, okay? Totally kills the views. Totally kills the breeze. So maybe parts of Margate, finally, can we stop this project? Is that possible? Our outgoing governor, probably less than a 15% approval rating. That's right. This project is just a pet project of an outgoing governor with less than a 15% approval rating. That's the sad part about it. This will not help anybody. It just spends money. And some elected leaders in the Down Beach area, when they say, well, we need this stuff, it's good for us. It's like bad medicine. You need it, but it's going to really help. And when you find out that person who's a proponent of this stuff, that he works for the state of New Jersey, you just shake your head. a big face palm. That's why people don't trust most politicians. But that person's so busy right now with prescription fraud and all that. Can't blame them for not worrying about these little things like dunes and property values and elevated bacteria levels and contaminated sand possibilities. Thank you. Downbeachbuzz.com. Please sign up for our email newsletter. Please share that information. We do need for you to support all the sponsors, all the advertisers, all the businesses that we promote in our website, downbeachbuzz.com. Please support them because they support us, and we need alternative media. We need different viewpoints. You can't just trust a one newspaper town and tiny little radio stations that are wearing blinders. DownBeachBuzz.com.